When it first hit, San Diego was one of the first places that we had a plane land with people evacuating Wuhan, China. And so from the very beginning, we've almost been an epicenter. There's been many things that have happened here in our border town with regard to migrant families and asylum seekers coming through. And so I've been involved in those aspects. Now, our county is the size of the state of Connecticut. We have 18 municipalities, more than 15 tribal Indian nations. So working with healthcare providers and being responsible for their education on this brand new disease, I was supporting our EMS director, who is an international superstar. Christy Koenig has literally written the book on international disasters and that response. There was so much need for information. No one knew anything. I mean, we were reading probably 12 hours a day. I mean, it was like being in, you know, medical school or residency studying for your exams again. Everyone was petrified. This had not been done before, but the idea was just to help out the healthcare providers and individuals who were saying, I don't know what to do about this situation. I have a cough, I have a cold. So what we did, again, with the freedom of just being told, hey, you're in charge of this healthcare sector, you know, we haven't had a pandemic in the last 100 years, figure something out. That then led to the monoclonal antibody treatment. The way that I start off explaining monoclonal antibodies is we have a medication that takes 30 minutes to infuse one time, and you have an 85% reduction in your risk of hospitalization or dying. Given our work with the community, and understanding what the disparities were by zip code, by race, by ethnicity, by age, we were able then to know that we needed to open those monoclonal antibody regional centers. We're reaching out to doctors and nurses and dentists and acupuncturists and chiropractors and home health and anyone that's a trusted health messenger, because those are the people to which an individual goes to seek guidance. We have a three-prong approach, or I call it the three legs of our stool in the healthcare sector, and it's listen, engage, and support. It was so easy to work with Asper. It was amazing. Dr. Red was available literally 24/7. He and Christy, as colleagues, were able to communicate by text back and forth. At first, it was trying to figure out how to get resources through the state or directly through Asper and some of that stuff. But we set up in San Diego, we set up apparently the first partnerships among community organizations with state and with Asper. If you do get COVID, if you start to have symptoms, if you've been around someone and you test positive, then go in and get your treatment, please, so that you can go back to work sooner, so that you can be there for your family. It's a simple message. People don't go without treatment for pneumonia. Our goal is to prevent people from getting COVID, to prevent people from giving COVID to others, and to prevent people from dying of COVID. And if monoclonal antibodies are part of that arsenal, then that's something we as public health officials need to figure out better ways to explain that. And we've treated 370 people since February just in those two sites. We just have to work harder to get the message out. And that means on Indian reservations. And we have plenty of those in San Diego. But this model is something that works. It reached people who we weren't reaching otherwise. I think that our healthcare workers in that broad sense not only need support, but also we're going to have even more repercussions in our health system in the future. I need to keep fighting for it, and I will, but I also need to think of how can we get more people vaccinated? Because if we get them vaccinated, or if we can use these resources to get people vaccinated, then they won't even need monoclonal antibodies. And so there always has to be that silver lining. I was going to say gold lining, and I think it is a gold lining in some sense. It's my life's mission, my dream job is to be able to help serve underserved communities and improve their health and well-being, and thereby improve our community.